Would you like to stand, please? Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We have come together in the name of Christ to offer our praise and thanksgiving, to hear and receive God's holy word, to pray for the needs of the world, and to seek the forgiveness of our sins, that by the power of the Holy Spirit, we may give ourselves to the service of God. So would you like to sit, please, as we spend a moment in quiet, reflecting on the days and the week gone past. Bring before God all our memories of this week, all that we have to be thankful for, all that's given us joy, as well as all that's given us concern. We acknowledge the part that we play in making our households and our communities the places that they are. Jesus says, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is close at hand. So let us turn away from our sin and turn to Christ, confessing our sins in penitence and faith. Lord God, we have sinned against you. We have done evil in your sight. We are sorry and repent. Have mercy on us according to your love. Wash away our wrongdoing and cleanse us from our sin. Renew a right spirit within us and restore us to the joy of your salvation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Father of all mercies cleanse you from your sins and restore you in his image, to the praise and glory of his name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed is the Lord, for he has heard the voice of our prayer. Therefore shall our hearts dance for joy, and in our song will we praise our God. Blessed are you, Lord our God, creator and redeemer of all. To you be glory and praise forever. From the waters of chaos you drew forth the world, and in your great love fashioned us in your image. Now through the deep waters of death, you have brought your people to new birth by raising your Son to life in triumph. May Christ your light ever dawn in our hearts, as we offer you our sacrifice of thanks and praise. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever.
Amen. The reading is from Paul's epistle to the Colossians, chapter 3. I'll begin at verse 12. Then put on the garments that suit God's chosen people, his own, his beloved. Compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Be forbearing with one another and forgiving where any of you has cause for complaint. You must forgive as the Lord forgave you. To crown all, there must be love, to bind all together and complete the whole. Let Christ's peace be arbiter in your hearts. To this peace you were called as members of a single body. And be filled with gratitude. Let the message of Christ dwell among you in all its richness. Instruct and admonish each other with the utmost wisdom. Sing thankfully in your hearts to God with psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. Whatever you are doing, whether you speak or act, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The sign of the Son of Man will appear in heaven, and then all the tribes of the earth will mourn, and they will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he will send out his angels with a loud trumpet call, and they will gather his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branches become tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see all these things, you know that he is near, at the very gates. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, our Christ.
I speak in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Not in being elite and distinctive. And so he urges them to turn away from the Gnostic rituals that reassure them how special and clever they are, and instead to turn towards practical service and love. I'll just remind you of those words. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another. And if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other just as the Lord has forgiven you. So you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. This, Paul urges them to understand, is where their specialness lies. It lies in their understanding that they are called to love as Jesus loves. This message is both disturbing and reassuring to the church. It is reassuring because it opens up faith to every single one of us. New life in Jesus is not restricted to a certain few who are gifted with special understanding or secret knowledge. It is available to all who have love in their hearts. And we all have love in our hearts. But it is disturbing because when we read this, we're aware of how very far we fall short. Which of us can honestly say that we express compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience in all our communications and endeavours? To consistently embody these things requires strength that we simply do not have. Where then does this leave us? Like the rich young man in an earlier gospel story, do we just disappear into the middle of the night in despair? We do not. Paul's next line is, and let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body. Be reassured, he is saying, to the Colossians and to us. You are called. You belong to Christ. Not because you deserve it, but because of who he is. And what he has called us to, continues Paul, is peace of mind and thankfulness. At a time when our minds are troubled and anxious about the present and the future, peace of mind can seem a rare and fragile thing. Paul gives us a clue as to how we might achieve it by pointing his readers back to the idea that it is together, as a body, as a church, that we are called to peace. And we might consider, as we go forward as communities, as a church, as a nation, the responsibility that we bear to guard and support one another's mental health, as well as each other's physical health, as we tread these waters together. Christ's peace, we are told throughout the Gospel, is a peace which the world cannot give. It is a peace, as our final blessing each Sunday reminds us, that passes all understanding. A peace that is incomprehensible by any normal rationalisation. It is a peace that the saints of God have found in wartime, in poverty, in persecution, in illness, indeed, in pandemics. It is a peace that can only be found in prayer and in thankfulness. And it is a peace which can be supported and grow within the body of the church. May the peace of the Lord be with us all. And may we find some thankfulness to carry us through these times. And may we know how much we are loved, and find ourselves able to demonstrate that love to our neighbour. For Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. we affirm our faith together in the words of the Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen.
In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. And so we pray for the peace of the world. This morning we pray for those countries that are not only dealing with a pandemic, but also unrest and civil strife. We pray for peacemakers, diplomats, and negotiators around the world. And we give thanks for all they do to foster cooperation and understanding. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our own country and our national and local government departments, and for all who seek to implement increasingly complex legislation. We pray for the police and those who work in the justice system, for all businesses, charities, arts, sports and leisure organisations, and all those who play a fundamental part in the structure of our society. We pray for patience and resilience for the present and hope for the future. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. We pray for the Church of God as we approach a busy and important time of year where many look to us for comfort. We ask that God will be with us in the planning, implementation and participation of our All Saints and All Souls services. And we pray especially for all those for whom All Souls will be a particularly painful or poignant time this year. We pray too for our keeping of Remembrance Sunday and Remembrance Day, praying for our armed forces and their families, and all for whom remembrance is particularly personal. Help us to worship you in spirit and in truth, whether in our own homes, in the street, or in the church. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our local community, giving thanks for all who enhance our daily life. We pray for our local shopkeepers and others who work in hospitality, tourism or the arts, and those who work in the teaching and caring professions. Be with them in their various challenges, disappointments, anxieties and frustrations, and help us to support them as we are able. Lord, in your mercy, hear. We pray for those amongst us who suffer in body, mind or spirit, for the housebound and the lonely. Today we pray especially for Rosemary, Anne, Joyce, Val and all those known to us. We pray too for all those whose suffering is known to God alone. We pray for those we love but see no longer, especially for Bob Hembrough. May he rest in peace and rise in glory. We pray for all those who are approaching anniversaries of death or who are awaiting memorial services. May they know Christ's peace and his presence with them in their grief. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Finally, we pray for ourselves, for the peace which passes all understanding, and for a community that finds ways to prioritize love. Help us to be thankful for all that we have, gracious and forgiving to our neighbour, and hopeful that your love can bring the joy of heaven into all circumstances. Merciful God, teach us to be faithful in change and uncertainty, that trusting in your word and obeying your will, we may enter the unfailing joy of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Gathering our prayers and praises into one, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be among us and remain with us always.